It may seem unrealistic that an all-natural earth element like lithium could prevent and slow the complex and devastating diseases of Alzheimer's and Parkinson's, but it's true. What is the evidence supporting this? What's the most promising lithium dosage? And what else do you need to know about monitoring lithium therapy? Stick around and I'll let you know. Dr. Tom Gattuso, professor of neurology at the University of Buffalo and movement disorder neurologist. If you haven't heard about our recent clinical trial results using lithium aspartate therapy in patients with Parkinson's disease, click on the link that just appeared above for a full review. Briefly, we found that therapy with lithium aspartate taken by capsule twice daily was associated with a statistically significant reduction in a very important blood biomarker called neurofilament light. These results imply that lithium aspartate therapy may be protecting brain cells from dying, slowing down the progressive worsening of symptoms, and improving Parkinson's disease patients' futures. Because blood neurofilament light is a very important biomarker reflecting brain cell death in both Alzheimer's and Parkinson's disease, lithium aspartate therapy has the potential to provide these long-term benefits for patients with either of these diseases, and also to prevent these diseases. In fact, there was a study recently published from a prominent Harvard research group showing that Alzheimer's disease may actually be caused in part from lithium deficiency in the brain, leading to accelerated brain cell death. I put a link to this Harvard study in the description below. So if lithium therapy can prevent and slow Alzheimer's and Parkinson's disease, what's the best lithium dosage to take? In other words, what lithium dosage is associated with the greatest degree of brain cell protection or neuroprotection as measured by the change in blood neurofilament light? In order to best answer this question, we need to dive into the details of our study results. But before we do, it's important to understand that the best way to monitor lithium therapy dosing is by monitoring each individual's blood lithium level at different lithium dosages. This is because people vary greatly in terms of how well they eliminate lithium from their bloodstream. One person taking 50 milligrams of lithium a day can have twice the blood lithium level as another person taking the exact same lithium dosage of 50 milligrams a day. In our clinical trial, we found that the group with an average blood lithium level of 0.32 millimoles per liter had the greatest and a statistically significant reduction in blood neurofilament light, while those with lower blood lithium levels did not. This implies that a blood lithium level of about 0.32 provides significant neuroprotection and may decrease long-term disability and improve patients' futures. The lithium aspartate dosages needed to achieve this blood lithium level range from 50 milligrams to 100 milligrams a day among the patients in this group. The take-home message is the only way to know which specific dosage will provide a blood lithium level of 0.32 in an individual person is to have the person's doctor monitor the blood lithium levels as the lithium dosage is adjusted. Another very important reason it's necessary to monitor blood lithium levels is because too high of a blood lithium level can cause bothersome side effects, including sleepiness, dizziness, nausea, vomiting, and balance problems. In addition, having too high of a blood lithium level can also cause thyroid and kidney dysfunction. These are outcomes nobody wants. The bottom line is anyone taking more than 10 milligrams a day of a lithium dietary supplement, such as lithium aspartate, needs to have their doctor monitor their blood lithium levels until the ideal lithium dosage for that individual person is identified, and also their kidney and thyroid function blood tests at least twice a year. If your doctor is agreeable with you taking greater than 10 milligrams of lithium a day, I will post another video detailing how your doctor should monitor and adjust lithium dosages in case your doctor is not familiar with this. I'm certainly not recommending that anyone take more than 10 milligrams of lithium a day at this time. This is a decision that each person should make after a discussion with their doctor, and there clearly is much more research that needs to be performed. If you'd like to hear more about these topics and protecting brain health with aging, click the like and subscribe buttons below. And remember, a great way to protect your brain is to exercise every day.